Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. The Frostbite engine and its networking were designed to support 64 players, destruction, vehicles and a physics-based bullet simulation. But it did require a rather big rework back in 2014 to get the servers to run at 30 Hz, and even more optimizations were required to achieve a stable 60 Hz for 64 players in Battlefield 1 on PC. I mention this because I feel that Epic is in a similar place where DICE was about 4 years ago, as the Unreal Engine simply was not fit to provide a reasonable tickrate for Battle Royale games with their 100 players. Especially during the early stages of the match, the server and the networking get crushed by the load generated by those 100 players. As a result, you get killed in very strange ways due to the tickrate of about 8 Hz, which I have shown you in my previous netcode analysis videos about PUBG and Fortnite. The server performance then improves as the match progresses, since there are fewer players left that the server has to deal with, which is one of the reasons why the hit registration and the delays feel a lot better as soon as there are less than 50 players alive. This performance issue affects both PUBG and Fortnite, as they use the same engine, the Unreal Engine 4. Now, even though we all know Epic has a game development studio, their primary business is to license their Unreal Engine to other studios so that they use it for their games. With the rising popularity of Battle Royale, Epic knew that they had to start to make their engine fit for that kind of game, not just to improve Fortnite, but also so that other studios would still license their engine to make such games. In a way, you can see Fortnite as the proving ground for the Battle Royale enhancements that are done to the Unreal Engine, which then become available to all developers who license the Unreal Engine for their game, like PUBG. Last month, Epic released the Unreal Engine version 4.19, which includes some major networking optimizations to enhance the server performance of games like Fortnite and PUBG, especially during the early stages of the match. These enhancements were added to Fortnite in patch 3.4, and in this video I will show you what kind of impact these have on the performance of the server and the network delay. Now, while I always do my best to keep the netcode analysis as simple as possible, you will still need to have some basic knowledge about computer networking, tick rates, update rates, network models, super bullets, lag compensation, packet loss, and a few other things, like how I do my network delay tests. So to keep the netcode analysis videos as short as possible, I've put all this information into a separate netcode 101 video, which you should have watched at least once before you continue with this video here. The card overlay in the top right corner of this video, as well as the link in the description down below, will both take you directly to that video. So before the 3.4 patch, the Fortnite game servers really struggled, as the tick rate only reached a stable 20 Hz once there were less than 50 players left. Now, after the patch, we get at least 20 updates per second from the game server even during the pre-round phase, so no more 8 Hz at any point during the match in Fortnite, which is a massive improvement. So Epic clearly achieved their goal to maintain a 20 Hz tick rate throughout the match. I hope that they will now push further to make this a stable 30 Hz next, as that will be another very big step forward that leads to a better online experience for all players. Now, what does this change mean for the up and downstream bandwidth that is required to play Fortnite? As you can see here, Fortnite needs very little bandwidth even when the server sends a stable 20 updates per second. The game also needs a bit less downstream bandwidth now after patch 3.4. Now, when you look at these numbers here, I want you to keep in mind that this is not a ranking nor a rating. I just want to show you how much bandwidth these games need so that you get a better idea if your connection can handle these titles. Now, how about the network delay that you experience in Fortnite? Last time I tested Fortnite, I could show you that there is clearly more delay during the early Mayhem than there is when there are less than 40 players left. The reason why I don't see any results for the damage delay test here is that I couldn't get my two test players onto the same server in 3.1. This time, however, I was able to get both players onto the same server repeatedly, and so I can not only show you the average damage delay of 63 milliseconds, but also that the network delay is now lower during the early stages of the match. Thanks to that stable server send rate of 20 Hz, there are no more spikes of more than 100 milliseconds at a player ping of 25 milliseconds to the server. When we then compare these results to PUBG, which runs at 30 Hz when there are less than 40 players left, then we can see that the tick rate is not the only defining factor when it comes to the network delay between two players. I will soon revisit PUBG to see if the optimizations of the last few updates brought down the network delay and how the new map affects the performance of the server. But honestly, I doubt that we will see a big improvement there until the developers include the changes done to the Unreal Engine itself, which resulted in the stable tick rate of 20 Hz in Fortnite. So I hope that the PUBG development team will be able to include these enhancements as soon as possible, and maybe we will see a stable 20 or even 30 Hz then. Now, when we compare Fortnite to other games on that list, like Battlefield 1, which runs at a stable 60 Hz, then we see average delay values that are not much lower than Fortnite's. However, what you must also have a look at here are the longest delays. A higher update rate does not only reduce the network delay, it also makes it more stable, and a bit of packet loss is less of an issue when you have more data packets to work with. So, while having a stable 20 Hz in a game like Fortnite is surely a great improvement, it's by no means a good enough tick rate for a fast-paced first-person shooter, which is why I really hope that Epic keeps pushing for a higher tick rate. Another thing that I mentioned in my last video is that the ping value displayed inside the network overlay is obviously broken, as it gets lower as the match progresses and even reaches 0 milliseconds at some point. This issue is sadly still here after patch 3.4, so don't trust the ping value that you see in the overlay. Another thing that I talked about in the past is lag compensation, or how the game's hit registration handles players who have a very high ping. In this example here, we have one player with a ping of 25 milliseconds who gets shot by a player with more than 400 milliseconds ping while he tries to get behind cover. The server does not care about the ping of the shooter. As a result, the player with the good connection to the server receives that hit very far behind cover, which can be a rage-inducing experience in a game where you have just one life and might lose a match as a result of this. When I show players such an example, then their first reaction is usually to demand a region lock and a VPN block. But these measures are actually useless, because even when you live right next to the game server, you can still have a ping spike of several hundred milliseconds. So the only reasonable solution to this issue is to limit how much lag the server will compensate for, which is what Battlefield 1 does, as I explained and showed in my Netcode 101 video. The most common cause of such massive ping spikes is buffer bloat. If you want to know more about that and how you can fix it, then you should check out the video that I have linked to in the description down below. Spoiler, you don't need a so-called gaming router running on outdated hardware for 200 bucks to prevent it. Speaking of connection issues, there were reports on Reddit that players who have a lot of packet loss or high latency variation would be able to run faster. I've tested this extensively and it seems that Epic has fixed that issue, as even very unrealistic packet loss and latency variation values could not trigger that problem in my tests, which is very good. So that's all for today. I will keep you updated on the progress that the developers make, and if you enjoyed this updated netcode analysis of Fortnite, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon, as YouTube's ad revenue is sadly not enough anymore to run a niche channel like mine. Without the awesome support that I get from my patrons, Battle Nonsense would not exist anymore. You can find a link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you can also find links to my social accounts in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris and this was Battle Nonsense.